which you just saw is a hyperlapse which I did in a big fat Indian wedding last week. So hyperlapse isn't something as simple as time lapse. It's like a moving time lapse which needs a lot of calculation like alignment, steps, exposure, aperture, focusing points, grid lines, image stabilization in the post. Lot of things. It's altogether a different ball game. Maybe I will just go ahead and do a detailed video about it next week. So in this video, I am just gonna tell you about how to get super sleek and quick hyperlapses with your Sony A7R3 just in few seconds. So without further ado, let's get started. So you don't need anything to get this done. All you need is a Sony A7R3 or Sony A6500 with a handheld good gimbal. I use a zoom crane version 1. So all you have to do is just switch on the camera, go to the dial SNQ mode, set it to SNQ mode, go to the menu, then SNQ settings, set the record settings to 50 frames or 60 frames depending on your PAL or NTSC settings, then frame rate needs to be 1 FPS. This is for the time lapse or hyperlapse mode. If you're not moving, it's a time lapse. If you're moving, it's a hyperlapse. So we're gonna move with a gimbal. So basically it's maintaining the alignment perfectly. So it's a hyperlapse. So that easy. Just hit record and it starts recording. Does the file inside the camera. You can just play and see the complete hyperlapse instantly. That easy and that's instant. I don't know how easy it can be without this SNQ feature. So that's all about this. You can really get some super smooth hyperlapses as long as you have a good gimbal and the SNQ mode is set perfectly. It does full HD at 50 Mbps, pretty cool. Much better than having 12 Mbps footages like the old A7 S2 and A7 R2. So this is pretty much set. If you have got any question, let me know in the comment section below. Smash the subscribe button if you haven't done it yet. And don't forget to click on the bell icon to stay updated. I will see you next time.